Hey, this is Lance with 20-Sided Knight, and today we're going to take a look at what is flanking in Starfinder. Before we begin, if you'd please subscribe, that would be cool of you. The rules for flanking start on page 254 of the Starfinder Core Rulebook, and to clarify things further, we're also going to take a look at the Reach and Threatening Square sections on page 255 of the same book. The rules for flanking are pretty straightforward and will give your group the edge when dealing with tougher threats. Flanking works especially well against larger creatures, due to how those large creatures take up multiple squares, in the event that you're facing a hulking crest eater or just some jerk in power armor. The benefit of flanking is while making a melee attack, you gain a +2 bonus to attack rolls as long as another creature is also in melee range,
and in order to threaten squares, you do need to be wielding a melee weapon or have access to natural weapons,
and threatens an opposite corner or border. This can be especially useful to those who plan on making a full attack and want to mitigate that -4 detriment as much as possible. A side note, this can be something a mechanic and their combat drone could take advantage of easily when they're working in harmony.
There are feats that can assist in threatening squares, thus gaining and giving the flanking bonus, such as the improved unarmed strike feat. On top of dealing additional damage, this feat allows you to threaten squares within your natural reach with your unarmed strikes, even when you don't have a hand free for an unarmed strike. You normally don't threaten squares with unarmed strikes.
A single creature's attack bonus gained from flanking can never be higher than +2 to a single target, even if there are multiple creatures flanking opposite corners or borders, such as when flanking larger creatures that might take up more than the normal 5 feet square. However, a single creature can give the flanking bonus to more than one creature if they're on opposite corners or borders from those receiving that bonus. If you're ever in doubt that you're flanking a creature, trace a line between the center of two creatures on opposite sides of the target. If that line passes through the opposite borders or corners and is obstructed from walls or such, good news, you're flanking, or bad news, you're being flanked. One important thing to consider, if you're making an unarmed strike but don't have natural weapons like the Vesk or Awakened Bear, you don't threaten others for flanking. Remember, you cannot give or receive the flanking bonus if you're not in melee range, and creatures with a range of 0 cannot flank a target. Having a melee range of 0 feet can be compensated for if you're using a weapon with the reach property, such as attack lash or lances, and some suits of power armor, such as the cargo lifter, grant the reach property. This is noted in the parentheses after the armor's size and doesn't apply to all suits, so be sure to check that out if it applies. On the other hand, if you're a larger creature, you can threaten more having more size to throw around. As an added bonus, for being large and in charge, large creatures typically have a natural reach. You threaten any square where you can make a melee attack, and a single creature can threaten multiple enemies. It doesn't require any additional actions to give or receive the benefits of flanking, but be sure to let your GM and other players know your intentions to avoid cheesing and to make sure that all at the table can get this bonus. Some creatures like elementals, oozes, and swarms of things are immune to being flanked. This could be a product of having omnidirectional awareness and being part of a collective, and not needing to focus on orientation. Touch spells such as the Mystic's 3rd level fatigue spell are a bit of a gray area. They can gain the +2 bonus from flanking, but since they are unarmed strikes without natural weapons, they don't threaten adjacent squares. This can be up to GM discretion or a player screaming at their GM until they give up. That should hopefully answer the question, what is flanking in Starfinder? If this video has been helpful, please subscribe. If there are any other topics that you would like me to cover, drop a comment and I will do what I can to get to them. Thanks again for watching 20-Sided Knight, and bye for now.